Hello, I'm Alarmix and welcome to the channel. My subscribers out there know that I'm a pretty experienced Bangalore player. I mean, I've gotten to know her abilities pretty well. I mean, I only use Bangalore in Apex, so. Anyways, I came up with this video idea on ways to use Bangalore smoke. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Just a disclaimer though, a couple of these tips might sound a little bit obvious, but who knows, sometime down the road, it could help keep them fresh in your mind and it could, I guess, benefit you sometime. But I have a lot of really helpful tips for you guys, so let's get into these. Alrighty guys, getting into the first tip, we kind of see a common thesis that when you shoot down your Bangalore smoke, the enemies kind of expect you to run through it. So a way that you can differentiate yourself from other Bangalore players and improve yourself is maybe not always running through the smoke when you shoot it down. So my first tip is to use it to bait while you heal. So say in the battlefield and you get shot and you just really need a break, and maybe the enemies are even kind of pursuing you, you can shoot down the smoke and then go into like a different corner away from the path of the smoke to heal. And I mean, me myself, I find that it works, you know, sometimes even better than shooting it down at your feet and trying to heal you. Like, try it out, maybe it'll work for you. Alrighty guys, moving into tip number two, this is kind of an obvious one, but to be a good Bangalore player, you should use it. You should use the smoke to rez. If you don't want your teammates to hate you, and if you want an easy rez, assuming the teammates are not so close, this is what Bangalore smoke is meant to do. Tip number three, all of my fellow Bangalore players out there know about this one. If you're ever in a losing situation, say your teammates are getting downed, you're low on health, or if you ever get that, I hate it, you get third partied, you can use the smoke to run away. Along with Bangalore's speed boost, putting smoke on the ground, like as long as there isn't a Pathfinder or something or an Octane, like you're gone. It's a pretty good way to go. Tip number four, you can actually use Bangalore smoke to figure out the color of people's armor. Now this is kind of a tough one because there might not be a lot of situations where you can sit there and shoot smoke at people to just figure out the color of their armor. But say, maybe you're behind someone and you want to use your digital threat. Maybe you can shoot smoke at the back of the enemies. That can do like splash damage, so you can damage two enemies at once and you can call out the color of armor and then use your digital threat sight to shoot them. Or like the way that I would use it is if you know someone's camping in a corner somewhere, like in a room, you can actually shoot smoke into that room. It'll damage the enemy and you will know what color of armor they have. So I think that's a pretty cool one. Moving on to tip number five, this is the most overpowered way to use Bangalore smoke in the entire game. You should be taking advantage of this tip as often as you can while you're using Bangalore. What I'm talking about is you should be using Bangalore smoke to take advantage of the digital threat sight. If you want an easy tip on how to 1v3 squads, slap the digital threat onto the R99 and while you're using Bangalore, put smoke all over the ground and you'll be putting up a pretty decent fight no matter who you're facing. I know that there's a lot of tips in this video, and it's going to be tough to remember them all, so that's why I'm going to be leaving a link to a form in the description that'll have all of the tips from the video in it. So just save the link somewhere, and you know, every once in a while you could just go back to that link and check out the tips again, so you don't have to come back to the video. Moving on. The sixth way to use Bangalore smoke is to throw smoke on your opponent when attacking. Now why shouldn't you throw smoke like in between you and your enemy to make sure you get like a further push? Well, I'll tell ya. If you throw smoke on your opponent, it'll let you first of all reposition, and second of all, the enemies will probably come out one at a time from the smoke to shoot at you. So this lets you and your team first of all take less hits, and second of all, when they come out of that smoke, all of your teammates will be focusing their fire on that one guy. If you throw your smoke in between you and the enemy, it kind of does the reverse of this and screws you up. Number seven on my list is to throw smoke on your opponents when you're defending. It's kind of like the last one, I guess, but I mean, slightly different things is that they're not going to be head glitching, so you might do damage with your smoke. And also, when all of a sudden smoke is appearing and they got hit by it, you know, it might kill their confidence a little bit. But really, the main thing here is that it'll isolate the first opponent coming through the smoke. So that first guy coming through, he's going to get shot at first and he's not going to have any help from his teammates. There's another really good way to use Bangalore smoke. With tip number 8, you should use Bangalore smoke paired with the Bloodhound ultimate. This is another super great way to use Bangalore smoke. Bangalore's ultimate is so good in the first place but if you put Smoke on the ground and that Bloodhound on your team pops his ultimate, as long as that player is decent, like, you have a very good chance of winning. It's a very good pair to use. Like, if you guys haven't tried pairing Bloodhound and Bangalore together when you're choosing your legends at the beginning of the game, I strongly recommend it. It's pretty cool. Tip number 9 on ways you can use Bangalore's Smoke is use it to distract then attack. Going back to what I said at the beginning of the video, when you throw down Smoke, most people are going to assume that you're going to at least try to run through it or like use your digital thread on it. Most people aren't going to think that you're just going to throw it on the ground and leave it there. So a really good way that you can take advantage of this is throw Smoke on the ground and then go attack from a completely different angle. This can really help take your Bangalore game to the next level. Alrighty guys, a little bit of a spoiler alert. There's 19 tips in this video, and you're not gonna find information like this anywhere else on YouTube. So if you guys have been enjoying and you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. Let's get into the next tip. Moving on to tip number 10, this one could be a little bit tricky to pull off, but who knows, every once in a while, it could be very rewarding. What I'm talking about is that you should try to use her smoke to draw attention between teams. Now, what I mean by this is, if say you're walking through a field and you see a team further back to your, like say left, and then further back to the right, and they haven't seen each other yet, you could actually shoot smoke in between those two teams. Both of the teams would probably hear the smoke and look towards it, and so it would draw attention between those two teams, and they'd probably start a gunfight. This is pretty much the definition of creating your own third party, and you really have to be in the perfect situation to where the two teams don't see each other and those teams don't see you. But once in a blue moon, if you can pull this off, I mean, that'd be pretty sweet. So my next tip involves the damage that Bangalore Smoke does. So if you didn't know, when you hit someone with Bangalore Smoke, it actually does 10 damage. And you actually get the opportunity to do splash damage, so say you could hit like 2 or 3 people and do 10 damage each. I mean, that's still nothing, but I mean, it's still something, I guess. So I mean, when should you actually use this? I mean, it's pretty weak. Well, say when you drop in the game and you're in a punch battle right at the beginning of a game, if you're like one hit and you can't get punched again, maybe the other guy guys one hit and you don't have guns, you could actually shoot smoke at the guy and kill him. I mean, that'd be one for the highlight reel, but that's just me. There's a way though that you can use Bangalore smoke damage to where it's a little bit more viable. A way that you can do this with tip number 12, use the smoke damage to see if there's anyone around the corner. So if you're chasing after someone and you're pretty sure that they were just running to reload and, you know, they sat in the corner, or for whatever reason that they're camping around that corner, you can shoot smoke into that room. I mean, it does pretty okay splash damage and it'll pop up with that little 10 damage and you can actually see where they are in that room. I think that is pretty cool, and when you can use it, you should. So just make sure to try it out. Tip number 13, this can kind of be called a dumb one. This is use Bangalore smoke as a third weapon. So if you ever find yourself in a situation that you burn through both of your weapons worth of ammo, or even just your first weapon if it's at the beginning of a game, and you find your opponent at a one hit, it could be a good idea to shoot smoke at them. So if they're at 10 damage or under, it could be a kill. But please peeps, only do this at your own discretion. It's probably not the most efficient way to finish off your opponent, but there is a small chance it could be. And if you do get it, it's probably the equivalent on a highlight reel to hitting a 360 no-scope. Like, that'd be dope. Alright guys, this is one that I gotta emphasize and you should try not to slack on. You should use Bangalore smoke for any kind of looting. So when it comes to loot boxes, care packages, or just like normal looting in general, if you're in the open, don't worry about wasting the smoke, just use it. You don't want to have to learn your lesson from all of a sudden getting hammered from behind. I know me myself, I've had to learn the hard way. Sometimes when I'm looting, all of a sudden I just get nailed in the back. And maybe some of you guys have had to learn the hard way. But please, just after watching this video, just make sure to use that Bangalore smoke to give yourself cover while looting in the open. The next tip you guys should know a lot about, but I have a special twist to this tip. Tip number 15 is to cover downed teammates even if you aren't rezzing them. Of course, when you're rezzing teammates, you should shoot smoke on top of them before you pick them up. But you know, the Mapex players out there, they can be so thirsty. Like, even if they're in the middle of a gunfight, they can just choose to shoot at the downed player over the person who's shooting them right in the face. So to combat this a little bit, I guess, you can shoot smoke at your teammate downed on the ground, even if you aren't planning on rezzing them anytime soon. The 16th way to use Bangalore smoke, I think, gets overlooked a little bit. When you're respawning a teammate and there's a firing squad practically waiting for them, it would really help your teammate if you would shoot smoke on the ground to cover them while they're respawning. It can be so frustrating to get shot when you're just trying to respawn and get back in the game, so your teammates are gonna really appreciate it if you can shoot smoke down for them. Tip number 17 is to cover your teammates if they're low. So an example of this is if you're sneaking up on a squad or trying to sneak up on a squad, and all of a sudden when your teammates gets blasted, trying to shoot at one of the three enemies that is mowing them down really isn't gonna do them a whole lot of good for your teammate. So maybe one of the only ways to save that one guy's life is to shoot smoke at your teammate. Honestly, I do this all the time and it makes for a pretty good Bangalore player. Alright, so we're about to get into tip number 19, and that's a lot of tips. So if you guys have been enjoying, make sure to subscribe. But anyways, tip number 19, our very last tip of the video, is make sure to use Bangalore smoke a lot. And honestly, this one thing was holding me back from being as good of a Bangalore player as I could be. I always kind of saved Bangalore smoke for like using the digital threat, like Bloodhound's ultimate, or like picking up teammates. But honestly, if you don't have a digital threat site, those things don't occur all that often. So just make sure to use all of the tips from the video and kind of pan them out. And dang, that might be a lot of tips to remember. So, you know, I'll put a form in the description that'll have all the tips from the video in it. And hopefully that'll help you guys out a little bit. So make sure to check it out. Anyways, guys, I'm Alarmix, and have a great rest of your day.